radio station which gives you all the latest news and spoilers from Albert Square. Live with Tom Versey. Hello and welcome to episode 7 of EastEnders FM. This is the series finale, well, mid-series finale of EastEnders FM until the show returns back for episodes 8 to 15 of series 1 in July. Yes, that's right, I haven't got enough time in the next few months to be able to do any more episodes, which is why I'm splitting the current series up into two parts. Reason being is so that you don't have to wait long between two different episodes, so I thought if I split it up on a good note, that means when we return next time, we won't have any delays or anything like that. So yes, I thought I'd do it for the best, and hopefully by then we'll have a great time. And of course, there is going to be a second series, like I confirmed, and that will hopefully be airing in the autumn on Spreaker, and you really don't want to miss it, because hopefully we'll be changing the show around a little bit. So on today's show, we'll have a discussion of what's been going on this week in EastEnders, and it's been great so far. We've also got a preview of tonight's episode, and you do not want to miss it because she's back. When I say one preview, I don't mean one preview. No, I mean two. Mm-hmm. And there's going to be an exclusive trailer for Janine's big return. Oh my god, you do not want to miss it. That's tonight at 7:30pm on BBC One, and if you miss it, I do not know what is wrong with you. And of course, we've got our usual fan mentions and some latest news and, of course, a look to next week's episode of EastEnders. So that's what's coming up on today's episode of EastEnders FM. Now, though, as promised, here's a preview of tonight's episode of EastEnders.
Nice, come on. What are you doing?
Seducing you.
You are a very sexy girl, but I just bought it as a gift. I didn't mean to seduce you, so...
Why, so soon after that, Janine Butcher returns to Albert Square, and oh my god, hello Michael, are the first words you're going to hear. And you do not want to miss the episode, and after hearing that, I'm absolutely really, really excited. Michael and Alice, well, Michael is seduced by Alice, and yeah, that looks really, really shocking. And obviously, Alice runs off, upset, and Kat wants to know why when she turns up, and that's when Janine Butcher returns to find that Kat's sitting at a dinner table for two. So it looks pretty good. And to help you out, to get you really, really excited for the episode, which airs tonight at 7:30pm on BBC One, here's a little preview again.
I loved you. The marriage was real. The child is very real. You destroyed it. You abandoned her. You think that's normal? No explanation, no apology. And I've been struggling.
Hello, Michael.
She's back. EastEnders, Thursday at 7:30 on BBC One and BBC One HD.
Now you know you really, really shouldn't miss it because it is on very soon, and if you miss it yet, you're making the biggest mistake of your life. Literally. So in preparation of tonight's episode, let's talk about the latest episodes we've had so far this week. So, it all kicked off Monday night following the big wedding drama and of course Sharon being guilted at the altar in the R&R on Friday night's episode, and oh my god, what an episode it was. Oh, I felt sorry for little Denny when Sharon had a go at him in the calf. I mean, all he wanted to do was be with Jack. It was so sweet. The biggest drama was, of course, with the Kirsty and Max thing, when Max obviously asked Kirsty for an abortion on Friday night's episode, and she told him on Monday night's episode that she wouldn't be forced into anything, so that was absolutely brilliant. And I really, really think that this whole Bianca-Steve situation is kind of confusing. I'm really just not sure. I mean, she realises, well, she realised on Monday's episode that Carol didn't end it with Steve, and she got really annoyed, and Carol promised to leave to meet Steve that night, sort things out. And then obviously realising she had a lot on her plate, Masood intervened by going to see him and left Karen in a pretty bad situation. So yeah, that wasn't really good of Masood. And then of course we had Tuesday night's episode of EastEnders, which was also very, very good, saying that, as Lauren exposed Kirsty's secret. She revealed it to Tanya at the end of last night's episode, and what a duff that indeed was. Now, of course, she wasn't prepared to keep Max and Kirsty secret, so she promised to tell Tanya the truth on Tuesday's episode, so on that day. And of course, she later joined Joey, Lucy, Whitney, and Tyler for a drink and a Vic, and she pushed herself a bit too far and obviously made Joey leave. So it's getting worse for Lauren. She's getting so much worse, and of course we've got the big breakup coming up between Joey and Lauren thanks to Lucy the evil cow. Anyway, so that was sad. And of course while Jack tried to visit Sharon's house, Phil's house, Jack and Denny, Sharon turned him away, insisting that he give up any right to care about Denny. And of course Sharon needed Jack's help later on when Denny went missing. So it was a really good episode, it really was. And of course he missed a chance when he left the square, and poor Sharon couldn't stop him from leaving. So we don't know where he's gone, but hopefully he'll be back sooner rather than later. So yes, it's been a great two episodes, and tonight's one will be so much better. You will absolutely stop. You will never stop watching, basically. And when I say so much better, EastEnders has always been the best, but it'll be better because we've got a comeback of a character that we all know and love as Janine Butcher. So there you go. It's that time of the show again, people, where we give some fans and some people on Facebook a mention on EastEnders FM. Okay, so my first shout-out is to Joe Burrows for his fantastic song selection in this episode, of course, with the song that's being played after this episode finishes. A shout-out to my friend Dan, who is amazing, and thank you for your help over all this time we've been at college. A shout-out again to every single fan on the page. I'm not going to say their names now, because I mean every single one of you. A big shout-out to all of you. And, of course, to everyone else that's received a shout-out this series, or part of the series, of EastEnders FM. Another shout-out to you all. That's Becca Dorman, Nikki Gaines, Kate Hibberwhite, all of you. And, of course, again to Chris Wood. Don't you want me, baby? I'm only joking, Chris. Okay, so that's it for the EastEnders shout-outs. Short but sweet, I guess. Now on EastEnders FM, I'm sure there's something I've got to tell you guys, and I don't know what it is. Oh wait, yes I do! So now on EastEnders FM, I've got to tell you that...
Oh no, you don't!
But Jean, they've got to know this. I'm not going to be able to speak to them until June. No, not even June. I don't even think I'll be able to speak to them until July. Please let me tell them.
How dare you?
Ow! That did hurt a bit, Dot. Oh. Okay, please, please. I really need to tell these people. Okay, so...
I am Derek Brining!
Oh! Okay. So, let me try again. And just to correct you there, Derek, you were Derek Brining. Until you popped your clogs in the middle of the square, so there you go. Okay, so I think that's cleared them all, and now I can tell you the secret that you need to know regarding something that's upcoming on EastEnders this year. So, baby... Well, from what I've just seen, for once in their life, a Dalek has just become a very good use. Thanks, Dalek. Okay, so I figured I'll tell you the secret at the end of the episode, because then on I can, you know, no one can disturb us. So then, just before we go, I'd like to say thank you to everyone who's been listening to the show so far in the latest series. I'd like to thank you all for the support that you've been giving, and especially those who are liking our page. And again to the David Witts page at www.facebook.com/ultimatedavidwitts, because if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be as big as we are today. So thank you ever so much to that page, and thank you to once and again, thank you to you. Yes, you, the person listening to this right now. Thank you for tuning in and sharing your opinions and everything you've done to help support us here on EastEnders FM. Okay, so before we go, I would just like to say, as I said earlier, we will be back in July for a couple more episodes of EastEnders FM before we then finish with the series and return in the autumn. It's not much more to report other than say that we hope you really did enjoy our seven episodes, and it's not really long until we return. I mean, come on, we've got May, then we've got June, and then I'm back. July, so you've only got 2 months to wait before Tom Versey is back presenting EastEnders, or hosting EastEnders FM. So, yes, it's not really that long to wait, but really, you know, you've still got EastEnders, you've still got some big storylines coming up, especially with Joey and Oren, the evil people. And, yes, so don't miss out on it, it's going to be absolutely brilliant. So then, I guess I should tell you that secret now, shouldn't I? Before I leave, I would like to give you something to keep you guessing, and the answer to this will be revealed very soon on EastEnders FM. Baby makes three, but which three does that mean? They'll have a fight on their hands to keep on the scene. I would just like to say thank you for listening to EastEnders FM. I really appreciate that.